Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests, a very warm welcome to the historic opening of the first Slovenian Consulate in Adelaide. My name is Adrian Vatovec, the Honorary Consul of Slovenia for Adelaide, covering the territory of South Australia. We will begin with the anthems of Australia and Slovenia. Acknowledge the Kaurna people, the Indigenous Australians, whose traditional lands include the area around the Adelaide Plains. It is my pleasure to welcome the Honourable Zoe Bettison MP, the Minister for Multicultural Affairs, the Honourable David Pisoni MP, a Shadow Minister for Multicultural Affairs, the Minister for Slovenians Abroad, the Honourable Gorazd, Dr. Zvone, Žigon, Secretary of the Office for Slovenians Abroad, Mrs. Novenka Goltz-Clark, the Honorary Consul for Slovenia for Queensland, fellow members of the Consulate Corps, Mr. Ivan Safuta, President of Slovenian Club Adelaide, Mr. Mark Starica, Treasurer at the Slovenian Australian Chamber of Commerce. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to welcome now here to give her speech, the Honorable Zoe Bettison MP, the Minister for Multicultural Affairs. Thank you.
Thank you, Adrian. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I was just admiring the beautiful blue sky. So we always encourage people to move to Adelaide. We know we've got someone from Queensland. We have one of the most livable cities in the world, and we really enjoy living here. Let me please acknowledge the Minister for Slovenians Abroad, the Honorary Consul for Slovenia, the President of the Slovenia Club of Adelaide, and my parliamentary colleague, David Pisoni. It's a great pleasure to be joining you here for this historic opening of the first Slovenian consulate in Adelaide. Let me start by welcoming, on behalf of the Government of South Australia, Minister Žmavc. I understand that you're only here for a very short time, but I hope you get to experience the cultural vibrancy of our city, which was recently voted as one of the top 10 cities in the world to visit. I know Slovenia, including your capital, is also renowned for its beauty. I understand that it's a wonderful tourist destination, very welcoming, safe and accessible. It is an honour for us that you are able to open the first Slovenian consulate in Adelaide and demonstrate by your very presence your nation's commitment to our dual citizens and to strengthening the ongoing relationship between our peoples. The Government of South Australia is committed to promoting a shared understanding of our diverse cultural communities and recognises the benefits they bring our society, including stronger trade and cultural ties. The local Slovenian community has worked hard to pass on its culture and values to the next generations through groups such as the choir that we'll be fortunate to hear from today. And of course, through the Slovenian Club, which has been a meeting place for people with Slovenian heritage for almost 60 years. From the Second World War onwards, South Australia has benefited greatly from the migration of people from Europe. As part of this journey, thousands of Slovenians have become valued citizens of our state. And now through the opening of this honorary consulate, the state government welcomes opportunities to strengthen the relationship between our countries. I wish the new Honorary Consul, Mr. Vatovec, much success in his new role, supporting the local Slovenian community and promoting closer ties between South Australia and Slovenia. On behalf of the Government of South Australia, I congratulate the South Australian Slovenian community on this historic occasion in the life of the community. We also look forward to working with you to strengthen our trade, economic and other links in the years to come. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I would like to now welcome the Honourable David Pisoni to the microphone.
Thank you very much indeed, Adrian. On behalf of the State Liberal Leader, Stephen Marshall, I thank the Honorary Consul, Adrian Vatovec, for inviting me here today, and to the wider Slovenian community of Adelaide, their friends and supporters, for giving me the opportunity to share this milestone with you. As the Shadow Minister for Multicultural Affairs, I enjoy meeting South Australians whose origins come from around the world. I believe it's important to appreciate the contribution of our multicultural community here in South Australia for Slovenian South Australians to have the Minister for Slovenians Abroad here today, Mr. Gorazd in Adelaide to officially open the Slovenian consulate is a tremendous recognition of the connection you as a community have made to Australia. As ambassadors of Slovenia, sharing your culture to the wider Australian community and successfully establishing yourselves here in South Australia. I know my father came from Milan in 1952, and there's a connection, of course, with Northern Italy and Slovenia. And he befriended a number of other migrants from Slovenia when he first came to South Australia. And I think it's fair to say those post-war migrants that came to South Australia were the pioneers of the multicultural community that we enjoy today. Many barriers had to be broken. It was a very English place, as my father tells me, back in 1952. Couldn't get coffee. Bread was square and white. And even for olive oil, you needed to buy that from the chemist because it was sold for municipal purposes. I see a lot of people nodding in the audience. Today marks the official recognition of the Slovenian contribution to our community here in South Australia and what will lead to increased engagement between the two countries through trade and investment, academic excellence and tourism. And it's interesting that Slovenia was the place that Harvey Norman chose to start to foreign operations. And he cited Jerry Harvey, when he made that decision nearly 10 years ago, cited Slovenia as the gateway, the new gateway into Europe, because of its proximity, because of its cheap cost of doing business. And that business has been running very successfully. And I think the attitude that the Slovenian government has to business will see it do very well. I was pleased that Slovenian minister signed an agreement with the Australian government this week during his visit to make it easier for student exchanges between the two countries. And I think, again, that's the work of the Slovenian community in Australia over the last 50 or 60 years that's made that happen. So thank you very much for the invitation to share this with you today, and congratulations on being officially recognised by your homeland by having your own Consul General here in South Australia. Thank you.
The Minister for Slovenians Abroad, the Honourable Gorazd, Žmavc, has travelled to Australia to open three new Slovenian consulates, and they are in New South Wales, Queensland and South Australia. The Minister has additionally opened the Slovenian Australian Chamber of Commerce and the Slovenian Australian Academic Association. He will deliver his speech in Slovenian, and an English translated version of his speech will be spoken by Dr. Zvone, Žigon, the Secretary from the Office for Slovenians Abroad. Dr. Žigon has travelled with the Minister Žmavc from Slovenia. In his previous posting, Dr. Žigon was Charge of Affairs at the Slovenian Embassy in Canberra. Minister Žmavc, welcome. Dobrodošli.
Spoštovana ministrica, spoštovani minister, thank you very much for your speech. Thank you very much for your visit. Today. Spoštovane gospe, spoštovani gospodje, spoštovani predstavniki slovenske skupnosti, dragi prijatelji, spoštovani rojaki. V veliko veselje in v veliko čast mi je, da lahko na današnji dan, zadnji dan svojega gostovanja v Avstraliji, v imenu Vlade Republike Slovenije, izvedem še eno tako pomembno dejanje, kot je otvoritev, uradno odprtje prostorov slovenskega konzulata na čelu z častnim konzulom Republike Slovenije, gospodom Adrianom Vatovcem. Ker se to dogaja le nekaj dni pred dnevom državnosti Republike Slovenije, naj ob te priložnosti spomnim, da ima naša država za sabo 24 resnično burnih, a na koncu izjemno uspešnih let. Po začetnih prizadevanjih in mednarodnem priznanju in uveljavitvi v mednarodni skupnosti, pri čemer je izjemno pomembno vlogo odigrala prav slovenska skupnost tukaj v Avstraliji, za slovensko besedo in za slovensko pesmijo. In pa z aktivnostmi, da je dejansko bila Slovenija priznana kot samostojna država. To je tudi vaš prispevek. Želim si, da v teh kriznih časih, tako kot že velikokrat v zgodovini, so naši ljudje pravzaprav pokazali in znajo tudi biti trdoživi, znajo biti iznajdljivi in, kar je posebej pomembno, znajo biti pogumni. Z veseljem ugotavljamo, da se krivulja spet obrača navzgor, kar se tiče gospodarske rasti, se povečuje in kljub še vedno prisotnim težavam in povečanjem varčevanju in optimizmu in samozavest se pravzaprav iz gospodarstva širi tudi na druga področja našega življenja, predvsem v cilju kvalitete življenja. S takšnim pozitivnim občutki sem prišel tudi v Avstralijo. kjer sem bil priča predvsem pozitivnim dogodkom. Namen mojega obiska je bil namreč med drugim tudi uradno odprtje prostorov teh treh konzulatov, zagon slovensko-avstralskega združenja, akademikov v Melbourneu, slovenske avstralske gospodarske zbornice v Sydneyju ter slovenske šole v Brisbaneu. In takšen je namen in kakšen je namen pravzaprav omenjenih ustanov. Čeprav je masovno, ni masovno, je pa izseljevanje Slovenije v zadnjih nekaj letih vendarle povečano. In ker gre za mlado, predvsem pa perspektivno populacijo, ki z domovine odhajajo odlično izobražena, bi želeli, da bi ohranili stik z matično domovino. Ne le na ravni zasebni stiko, pač pa tudi v obliki sodelovanja na vseh ravneh, od gospodarstva do znanosti, do športa in do izobraževanja. Kako ustvariti in zdrževati to vrstne mreže, tako doseči, da se bo beg možganov spremenil v kroženje možganov, kar je vprašanje ne samo za našo državo, ampak za države širom v svetu. Pomemben korak v to smer je prav imenovanje častnega konzula, leta skupaj z aktivnimi pripadniki slovenske skupnosti, lahko predstavlja svojevrstno povezavo med državama. Predstavlja most, bridge, ki lahko premaguje še tako velike geografske razdalje in pa tudi kulturne razlike. Odnosi med Slovenijo in Avstralijo so načeloma zelo dobri. Gospodarsko in ostalo sodelovanje je morda prešipko. K večjemu povezovanju na tem področju bo lahko odločno pripomogel pravčasni konzul. V tem smislu se zahvaljujem častnemu konzulu Adrianu Vatovcu za pripravljenost za opravljanje tega poslanstva, ki je pomembno in tudi odgovorno. Zato, gospod Vatovec, želim vam veliko uspeha in veliko sreče. Boste pa zelo dobro lahko sodelovali tudi z nami, ker smo za to zainteresirani. Zato z velikim upanjem in dobrovoljom, tudi uradnim odprtjem, želim veliko zadovoljstva tudi vsem Slovencem, ki živite tukaj na avstralskih tleh. Želim si, da bi z vami poleg avstralskih partnerjev sodelovalo čim več pripadnikov slovenske skupnosti. Če bo v zdravem poslovnem odnosu tudi vsaj 50 občutka pripadnosti istih kulturnim koreninam, bo naš skupni namen dosežen. V vsem navzočim, ki ste danes tukaj prisotni in za svojo prisotnostjo dajete občutek veličine tega dogodka, predvsem pa rojakom, že zdaj čestitam ob slovenskem dnevu državnosti, vsem skupaj pa se zahvaljujem za udeležbo na tem pomembnem dogodku in vam želim uspešen dan še naprej. Hvala lepa.
Ladies and gentlemen, excellencies, representatives of the government, Slovenian compatriots, dear friends, it is with a great pleasure and honor to be able to, during my first visit to Australia and the last day in Australia, fulfill such an important duty in the name of the government of the Republic of Slovenia as the official inauguration of the premises of the new Slovenian Consulate headed by the Honorary Consul of the Republic of Slovenia. As the Slovenian National Day is just within a few days, I would like to take this opportunity to stress that our country has had 24 really turbulent, yet on the other hand, exceptionally successful years. Following the initial hard efforts for international recognition and establishment within the international community, we have managed to achieve all ambitious and great goals, that is, joining the European Union and NATO, as well as other numerous international organizations. Last but not least, the standard of living of our people has been raised. The latter has been seriously threatened due to the economic crisis, which has severely affected our country and weakened economic and social stability. But precisely in these times of crisis, as so often in history, our people showed that they can be resilient, resourceful and brave. I'm pleased to note that the curve turned upward again, economic growth is increasing, and despite current difficulties, optimism and self-confidence is spreading from business to other areas of our lives. With such a positive perception, I came to Australia, where I was and I am attending positive events. One of the main purposes of my visit was to officially inaugurate not less than 3 consulates headed by honorary consuls, to launch a Slovenian-Australian Association of Academics, a Slovenian-Australian Chamber of Commerce, and to open a new school of Slovenian language and culture. And what is the purpose of those before mentioned institutions? At the time of previously mentioned crisis in Slovenia, we have not witnessed a massive immigration. However, a number of expatriates increased. As a young, promising population that is leaving its homeland well-educated, we wish they would maintain connection with the homeland, not only at the level of private contacts, but also in the form of cooperation in many fields, such as business, science, art, sport, and education. How to create and maintain such a connection and how to turn the brain drain into brain circulation are the questions of which largely depends the future of the Slovenian community in Australia, as well as forthcoming relations between Australia and Slovenia. Besides increasing role of the honorary consuls, vibrant associations and clubs with businessmen and scientists of Slovene origin among their members certainly represent an important step towards this aim. These associations and clubs, as well as honorary consuls, may represent a unique link between the two homelands, the one of origin and the new one. Moreover, they build bridges that can rise above huge geographical distances and certain cultural differences. Relations between Slovenia and Australia are exceptionally good. However, economic cooperation and cooperation in some other fields are still underdeveloped. You, dear honorary consuls or council, hold a crucial role in aspirations towards greater business interconnectivity. Therefore, I want to sincerely thank to you, Mr. Adrian Vatovec, for accepting this important mission, for your openness, readiness for cooperation and goodwill. Your loyalty to Slovenian roots and working spirit can be a bright example to descendants of Slovenian immigrants to Australia, as well as to newcoming educated compatriots. Therefore, with great hope and spirit, I officially open these premises of the Consulate of the Republic of Slovenia in Adelaide. And to the Honorary Consul, Mr. Vatovec, I wish all success and satisfaction in performing this very important function. I wish many members of the Slovenian community, in addition to Australian partners, will work together with you. If there is at least a pinch of sense of belonging to the same cultural roots in a healthy business relationship, our common purpose will be achieved. To all Slovenian compatriots, I congratulate for the Slovenian National Day. And I thank to everyone for attending this important event and wish you a successful and a beautiful day. Thank you. We have to have a little present for our new council. So the minister will give this, I don't know the word now for the, how do you say for the?
Cufflinks.
Okay, which it says, I feel Slovenia.
Symbolic.
For those who don't know, I feel Slovenia is a slogan of, official slogan of Slovenia. And Slovenia is the only country in the world that has love in its word Slovenia. It's L-O-V-E. So that's why we chose this as our official slogan. And also something that Adrian already has, but still, he already has this, but still he gets another one. It's a Slovenian heart, Slovensko srce.
Oh.
I think we cut the ribbon now.
So we can take pictures.
Dr. Žigon said I cannot have my hand on the microphone because you can't take photos properly, so I can listen to you. It is not only an honour and a privilege to be named the Honorary Consul of Slovenia and to host the first Slovenian consulate in South Australia, but this is also a recognition of the hard work that Slovenians in South Australia have put into building our community. Slovenians started migrating to South Australia en masse from the late 1940s, from post-World War II stricken Europe as economic migrants. Over this expanse of time, Slovenians have contributed magnificently to the development of South Australia, in addition to providing for their family both here in South Australia and by sending money back to their family in need in Slovenia during those early years. They have established a solid Slovenian community in Adelaide. As an example of the strong work ethic, high sense of community involvement, values of persistence, purpose and achievement, Slovenians in Adelaide have to date built two Slovenian clubs, the latest of which is in Dudley Park, a Catholic church located in West Hindmarsh, and have owned a farm near Harndorf. The Slovenian spirit has been well and truly established by the first generation of Slovenian migrants. They showed us how working as a group is far more effective and productive than trying to accomplish the same thing as an individual. Slovenia gained independence in 1991 and has been very busy in building a positive international reputation. Since 1991, Slovenia has become a member of the European Union, NATO, OECD, the Schengen area, and has adopted the euro as its currency. These are just some of the remarkable achievements that Slovenia has achieved in such a short period of time. Slovenia is strategically situated in Central Europe, which means that other major markets are within easy reach. In addition, Slovenia has the most important port in North Adriatic, the port of Koper, from where products can be distributed to countries to the west, north, east and south in Europe. The seabed of Koper is being made even deeper to allow even larger ships to berth there. The global financial crisis affected most of the world, including Slovenia, but there are positive economic signals this year that Slovenia is emerging from those very difficult times. The Revoz manufacturing plant, a subsidiary of Renault, like a motor company, hired an extra 1,000 workers toward the end of last year. These cars are made for the international markets. The Slovenian insurance company, Sava Re, reported a record profit for 2014. Žito, the Slovenian food company, had its best result in years in 2014. Slovenia's largest fuel retailer, Petrol, posted a 15% rise in full-year profit. The Triglav Insurance Group's profit was up 23% in 2014. Slovenia's Gorenje, a leading European manufacturer of household appliances, also lifted its profits in 2014. The Organisation for Economic Cooperation Development this month further upgraded its growth forecast for Slovenia for this year from 1.8% to 2.1%. The OECD believes Slovenia's economy will continue to expand on the wings of strong exports and public investments in infrastructure projects, which are partly funded by the EU. Slovenia was the leading Central or Eastern European country in 2013 when it came to investment in research and high-tech development. It was also the only one in the region to surpass the EU average in its field, as reported by the Financial Times of London earlier this month. Gross domestic product in Slovenia grew by 2.9% in 2014 compared to the Eurozone average of 0.9%. Are there Australian companies operating in Slovenia? Yes, perhaps the best known is Harvey Norman. Slovenia was the first country in Europe where Harvey Norman opened their first store. This was in Ljubljana, Slovenia's capital.
in September 2002. Harvey Norman currently has 5 stores in Slovenia. Asking Harvey Norman why they chose Slovenia, their answer is because of Slovenia's strategically located position in Central Europe, its lower cost of entry into Europe, the ability to test market before expanding to other parts of Europe, and the high quality of the workforce. We all know that Jerry Harvey is a very astute businessman. So if he is making a move into Slovenia, it would be very prudent for everyone else to take notice and evaluate their own potential engaging in Slovenia. Slovenia receives a significant amount of funds from the EU for project development. In the new budget period, Slovenia will be eligible to 3.2 billion euros, and the first tenders for projects up to the year 2020 budget will be opening soon. Slovenia is drawing up a smart specialisation strategy that will take into consideration Slovenia's geographic position, history and its natural industrial and intellectual potential, and setting its course towards sustainable technologies and services. These are all areas that Australian companies and South Australian companies can engage with Slovenia. Slovenia has accomplished its economic turnaround by a series of austerity measures and a successful export-led strategy. Slovenian exporting companies generated a profit of 1.34 billion euros in 2014, on top of 53 billion euros in sales revenues. A report by business analysis firm Bidstone shows. 17,628 exporters represent over a quarter of all companies in the country and employ 261,000 people. To further aid Slovenia's economic development, the strategy involves the sale of a number of state-owned enterprises. The plan is based on successful privatisation according to the blueprint of companies like Hydria, which now supplies major car marks like Porsche, Mercedes, BMW, Peugeot, Volvo and Jaguar. Its components include parts for the growing segment of the hybrid vehicles, which combine fuel and electric power drive. Hydria is now on the world stage. The Institute for Macroeconomic Analysis and Development noted in its publication published earlier this year that the performance of Slovenian companies improved significantly last year to reach the highest level since 2008. Slovenia's industrial output expanded by 4.2% in April this year from the same month a year ago, with major improvements due to a 6.1% growth in the manufacturing sector. The continued recovery of economic activity in Slovenia has also resulted in favourable trends on the labour market. Slovenian employers, according to a survey by Manpower Group Slovenia, predicts a seasonally adjusted 8% increase in hiring for the third quarter of this year. The latest employment forecast by the Slovenian Employment Services shows there is an optimism among the surveyed employers, who announced the total of 3,800 new jobs in the second half of this year. Slovenia is open for cooperation with Australia and South Australia in a wide field of endeavours, including business, education, health, sport, arts, agriculture, construction, and manufacturing. I won't be long. During his current visit to Australia, the Minister for Slovenians Abroad, the Honourable Gorazd, Žmavc, has opened 3 new consulates here in Sydney, Brisbane, and today in Adelaide. He has also opened a newly created Slovenian Australian Chamber of Commerce and a newly founded Slovenian Australian Academic Association. The above activity declares that Slovenia is open for business with Australia, or as he said in cricketing terms, the innings has been opened. And the Slovenian Consulate in Adelaide is here to act as a facilitator between our two great countries. On this occasion, I would like to thank also my family, Irene, Eric and Cassandra, for your tremendous support in my role as Honorary Consul, and my late mother and father, who were very proud Slovenians and from whom I acquired my love of Slovenia. I'm also proud to be a
Slovenian. Thank you very much.
Okay, I think that's my speech. Thanks. that'll do. A Slovenian event would not be complete without a cultural component, as culture plays a very important part in Slovenian society. This is also fitting, as in a few days' time, on January 25th, we celebrate the National Day of Slovenia. So we'll kick off with a few songs with the Slovenian choir. These people have been singing for the last 23 years, and they have been the backbone of our Slovenian culture here in Adelaide. Okay.
Slovačka je 7% probao, no? Last night I received mail.
It's a tub of Islam.
Just wait a bit. The guys are just organising their pages.
Just have a look at Charlie there, younger.
Charlie. He's got game. He's the younger Charlie, eh? Okay.
Sem slovenska deklica, milka mieni me. Sem obraza bistrega, pravno imam srce. Laske imam rumene, in so lepo zbe.
Catherine Pistor. She's a third generation Slovenian Australian.
Who's next?
We have the poem.
Oh,
sorry. Mr. Ivan Lagisha.
Yeah.
Ljuba mati, odkar zakrkljeni sovraštvu razredno bedne bolečine, na vse strani sveta smo se v bridkosti razbežali, čeprav brsteš, vseeno smo spoznali, na zadnje vse, prav vse premine. Vendar naj bomo vse maltja razpeti, iz naših ust besede svete materine nam nikdo nikoli več ne more vzeti. Tako bi radi danes, ljuba mati, se v domovini stavo divigali v življenju in te z občutkom gledali v brstenju, prešinjeli v ljubezni, s tabo se smejali, ti v dano hvalo poli in ti v žgalščino dajali, tebi ljubljeni edini. Zato nam, draga mati, preširnih misli sprejmi naše čute, zazivaj nas ponovno v lepe stare čase in naše želje združi z vami. Odkar si nas vtisnila pečat svobode, v naših srcih ni nič več tegobe. Sedaj, ko k bratu pride brat, z dlanjo v dlani rajamo v omami, glej, glej, v tej opojnosti pijani, vsakdo se čuti zopet mlad. Da ne bo treba sinom tvojim na veko veke tujo prst orati, in ker občutki nam še vedno k tebi zakipijo, ko v miru spali bomo kje na tuji trati, tod, onod in onstran, spomni se nas, spomni tvojih zvestih, ljuba mati.
I got the job of translating this into English, so for the Slovenian speakers, I apologize if I got something wrong. Dear Mother, since hardened in class hatred, miserable pain, to all the ends of the earth we in sorrow dispersed. Though bursting, nevertheless we recognized that at the end, everything, absolutely everything, passes away. However we might be here or there spread, from our mouths, the sacred maternal words no one can ever again take. Thus, we would like today, dear Mother, in our native land, be with you to raise ourselves in life, and with feeling watch you budding, pervaded in love, with you laughing, to you devoted praise sing and burnt offering give, to you, our soul beloved. Therefore, dear Mother, proud thoughts accept our senses, lull us again into the beautiful old times, and our desires merge with yours. Since you set upon yourself the seal of freedom, in our hearts there is no more pain. Now, when brother comes to brother, and hand in hand dances to stupefaction. See, see, in this drunken intoxication, everyone feels young once again. So there will be no need for your sons to forever and ever foreign soil plough. And because our feelings continually swell for you, when in peace we will sleep somewhere on foreign turf, here, there and beyond, remember us. Remember your faithful dear mother.
again, we will hear the delightful voice of Miss Catherine Christophe.
Thank you.
of Dionne Baker, and you can see her around town, the musicals and opera productions. Is that right?
Yep, that's correct. Are you okay? I start rehearsals for Big the Musical in the at the end of this month. So okay. That'll be on in October.
All right, we'll see you. One more song, since this is a celebration. One more song that Slovenians love to sing, and this one's it. And if you know the words, please join in. From here, we move to Slovenian Club Adelaide for lunch, and I look forward to seeing you down there. Thank you very much.
Thank you. The minister is happy that he had a chance to briefly at least meet the Slovenian communities all around Australia. He thinks that the Slovenian community really contributed a lot in the past years to Australia, and also wants to thank you for keeping up with your Slovenian activities, keeping up with Slovenian identity. And he thinks that Slovenian community, and with what we did now in those couple of days also, the consulates and so on, will contribute into greater or bigger, stronger cooperation between the countries, the two countries in economic, scientific and all other fields.
Še enkrat bi želel izkoristiti to priložnost in se zahvalim za tako velik in lep obisk. Namreč prijetno se presenečen, da slovenska hiša dejansko, kot mi je rekel predsednik, tedensko, vsako nedeljo se dobite tukaj, da ste aktivni, da imate več kot 300 članov in to je zelo pomembno za ohranjanje slovenstva. Mi bomo pa naredili tudi v nadaljevanju še več, da bo to povezovanje tudi v interesu mlade generacije, druge in tretjih rodov, predvsem v teh odnosih, ki jih bomo spostavljali z častnim konzulatom, z gospodarskim klubom, z klubom znanosti, ki jih spostavljamo zdaj v času tega srečanja in pa obiska v parlamentu.
The minister is looking forward for the future cooperation with the Slovenian community. We will do, our office for Slovenians abroad, we'll do everything we can to encourage further cooperation. We're looking for young people also, and we hope that with these activities, like honorary councils or consulates then, and the club of Slovenian and Australian businessmen and Slovenian Australian academics will help in this endeavor.
Jaz bi v tej priložnosti in priliki želel tudi izročiti priznanja ministra in pa Republike Slovenije in bi prosil dr. Žigona, da morda da eno kratko obrazložitev za priznanja, ki bomo danes v tem trenutku tudi podelili.
Okay, the minister wants to give now some presentations, some priznanja, we call it in Slovenian, to certain individuals. Our office does that here and there, and the occasion of the visit of the minister is one of the occasions when we can do that. Our rule says it's not possible to give more than three at a time, so we have three recognitions for three individuals, plus one more then later. And I will do call the name, and I will ask the person to come closer and get the recognition from the minister. So, and I will read it in Slovenian. We will start with the lady first. Come on. Republika Slovenija, Urad vlade Republike Slovenije za Slovence v zamejstvu in po svetu. Priznanje in zahvalo za dolgoletno delo v slovenski skupnosti in neprecenljiv prispevek k ohranjanju slovenske kulture in identitete v Južni Avstraliji prejme Danica Kaluža.
Oh my god!
Pridite, gospa.
Gospa Danica, iskrene čestitke in to priznanje, mogoče če se postavite tukaj malo, da bo je slika, samo malo.
Malo moče ste.
Malo
bi sem se še obrnil. Ja.
Okay. Še enkrat iskrena hvala in evo, to nam ne bo priznanje Slovenije. Ja, vaše delo, izvolite.
Torej, priznanje in zahvalo za dolgoletno delo v slovenski skupnosti in neprecenljiv prispevek k ohranjanju slovenske kulture in identitete v Južni Avstraliji prejme Tomo Leš.
Čestitke za vaše dosedanje delo in želimo, da boste še naprej vplivali. Ja, mogoče, da bo slika samo malo. Okay. Hvala lepa. Ja, še enkrat. Hvala lepa.
No, naj povem, da ta... naj povem, da to ne pomeni, da tisti vseh, vsi še eno bomo dali, ampak da vsi drugi pa ga niste zaslužili, ne, seveda ste ga. Samo pač enega treba, enkrat jeden, enkrat drugi, enkrat tretji pride na vrsto, ne. In tretje bomo pa dali priznanje in zahvalo za dolgoletno delo v slovenski skupnosti in neprecenljiv prispevek k ohranjenju slovenske kulture in identitete v Južni Avstraliji prejme Danilo Kresevič.
Evo, prvo vam pocijelim. Iskreno hvala za vse. In še bo se tudi naprej. Evo, mogoče skupna slika. Vidimo. Niste pričakovali, da si pa zaslužil. Ste prvo borec, ja.
In ker sem rekel, da pač vsi ne morejo dobiti priznanja, ker pa tudi imamo malo smo omejeni, ampak vseeno imamo pa še eno osebo, ki bi pa radi dali nekaj, kar sicer že ima, tako kot sem rekel za Adriana, enako, gospod, ki nam je danes, ki je napisal že številne pesmi in ki je danes tudi bral poezijo, gospod Legiša, prosim, če bi prišli po slovensko srce, ki ga sicer že imate, ampak to je pa CD muzika. Izvolite, prosim.
Iskrene čestitke, simbolično Danilo.
Tako ja pa še zadi se dobijo za skupnost, odlično.
Mače lepo.
Super
slika.
Odlično.
Hvala
lepo.
Hvala lepo. Hvala lepo.
Ja. Jaz sem dobil več long time noč.
Jaz bi tudi ob tej priložnosti izkoristil, imam tukaj pismo predsednika vlade, ki je me pooblastil, da dejansko njegovem imenu zastopam interese Slovenije in to pismo bom predal predsedniku društva. In morda boste kdaj ga predali.
This was now the translation for the English speakers. The minister had the honor to receive a letter from the Prime Minister of Slovenia to the Slovenian community in Australia. So he's giving this letter of the Prime Minister to the President of the club and also a DVD CD, Moja Domovina, My Homeland. Imamo še eno veliko priznanje, to pa je tako, ki ni za posameznika, ampak je za skupine ali pa za društva in tako naprej. priznanje in zahvalo ob 40-letnici delovanja za neprecenljiv prispevek k informiranju in povezovanju slovenske skupnosti v Južni Avstraliji prejme slovenska radijska oddaja Adelaide.
Anne-Marie?
Ja, temu iskrenim čestitke v imenu vlade za Republike Slovenije in še naprej ne bo ta glas naslednjih 40 let prisoten v Avstraliji.
Sorry.
Hvala lepa vsem skupaj.